therefore we are to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard. We are to give the more earnest heed. Say, pay attention.
Pay attention.
We are to pay attention to what the preacher is saying, because the preacher is your prosperity connection. God has called, chosen, equipped, qualified, sanctified, appointed, anointed, elected, selected, ordained the preacher to preach to you so that you will be connected to what God has for you. That's a greater blessing. How are you doing? There you go. How are you doing? I'm doing better. I'm doing better. I say that at least 10 times in the morning. I say it at least 20 times in the afternoon, and I say it about 30 times in the evening. I'm doing better. I'm doing better. I'm doing better. And no matter where the pain is coming from, no matter where it's happening, no matter what's going on, my confession is the same. I'm doing better. I'm doing better. I'm doing better. See, that's us. But how about the them? The them will tell you, I'm not doing so good. And the reason why you're not doing good is because you're not confessing what God will have you to confess. And if you don't confess it, you can't possess it. Hello? So God is wanting you to say what God has promised you that he will give you. If you say it and obey it, it will certainly and surely come to pass. How are you doing? I'm doing better. I'm doing better. Now listen to what he says. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard. Now hear this now. Lest at any time we should let them slip. See, it's easy to let what you heard slip. And when you let it slip, then you don't have what you heard. This is why we should rehearse what we heard in order for us to keep the faith that we have. Because fear is everywhere. My friend, listen to me. Fear is everywhere. Wherever you go, fear. Wherever you go, there's fear. This world is filled with fear. And in order for you to have encouragement, you need to hear faith. And how does God send faith? Frank, he sends it because he sends the mailman. And who is the mailman? The mailman is the preacher. And he says this in Romans chapter 10, verse 13 on through 17. He says, so then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And he tells us how faith comes. He says, because I'm sending you the preacher to preach to you, right? So therefore, faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Without faith, you are in fear. You're in doubt, fear, and unbelief. See, this world is a world of unbelief. It is a world of unbelief. And before you have faith, what you have is unbelief. You have doubt. This is a doubtful generation. It's a doubtful world. You doubt this, doubt that, doubt, 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 doubt. And when you move from doubt, you move from doubt to, listen, fear. You move into fear because fear is everywhere. Meaning you have every right and reason to be fearful. Because you live in this sin-sick secular world. And in this world, I mean, listen, when you watch the news and listen to the news, it's nothing but fear. Nothing but fear. You turn to the news station and everything is fear, 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 fear. I remember, you know, it used to be when I was a little boy coming up, on Saturdays, they would have cartoon shows. On Saturdays, they would have also sitcoms, Father Knows Best, Lucy. They would have all these kind of things that would make you be cheerful. But in the world that we live in today, everything is murder. Everything is killing. Everything is hurting. Everything is, it's just murder stuff going on. Now, my wife, she loves the mystery stuff. I just can't watch that stuff. Why? Because fear is everywhere. Doubt, fear, and unbelief. This is what this world consists of. Doubt, fear, and unbelief. This is the reason why it used to be, and I would take to some degree, maybe it still is this today, but it used to be when you had to go to court and you had to swear in, they would tell you, do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, or nothing but the truth? So help you God. Because if you don't have so help you God, you ain't telling the truth. The truth ain't God. If you don't have a God that can help you tell the truth, the devil is going to encourage you through doubt, fear, and unbelief. You're not going to be truthful. Hello. So that's why they included, so help you God. And on your money tells you, in God we trust. The money that you have, before you spend your money, read it. It's telling you, in God we trust. Whether it's a dollar, whether it's a $5, whether it's a $10, whatever, the money is telling you it's in God we trust. Because see, if we don't trust God, and the only way we can trust God is by hearing the word of God. If you don't hear the word of God, then what it is, it's unbelief, because it's a lack of faith. And then from a lack of faith, it's little faith. And from little faith, it's no faith. So you end up with the lack of faith. But when you come to a church such as this, you want to hear the word of God. And the word of God brings you the faith. It brings you faith. Now, the sad commentary is a lot of people hear the word, but they do not operate in faith. And this is why he says, for unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. It was preached to both of us. For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them, but the word preached didn't profit them. It profited me, but it didn't profit them. Why? Not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. It wasn't that they didn't hear the same thing that us heard, but they did not obey what us obeyed. And this is what he is telling us here. For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them. Now I want you to look at this again. In Hebrews chapter 2, this time I want to move to verse 2. Hebrews chapter 2. Look my way just for a moment. The word Hebrew means one from the other side. Can you say that? One from the other side. That's what Hebrew means. What? One from the other side. And the question becomes, what side are you on? What side are you on? Are you on the wrong side, or are you on the other side, which is the Lord's side? God had Moses to come out and says, who's on the Lord's side? See, because he's talking to the children of Israel. He's talking to God's people, but all God's people were not on God's side. They were on the side of unbelief. And you got so many Christians, they function in unbelief, doubt, fear, and unbelief. Notice what he says in chapter 2 of Hebrews, one from the other side, verse 2. He says, for if the word spoken by angels was steadfast. Now, when he says angels, he's not talking about angelic beings. The word angels mean messengers. In other words, glory to God, he sent the messenger. So I'm not tooting my horn. Please forgive me if it sounds like that. But he's talking about, Bishop, you an angel. It gives me chill bumps. You are a messenger. You are an angel. I'm sending you with a message. And this is what he says. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedient received a just recompense of reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation? How will we escape? You can't escape it. This is why a Christian end up down, depressed, vexed, troubled. Why? Because they do not receive the word from the angel, the messenger. Now go into your Bibles to the book of Hebrews chapter 6. Hebrews chapter 6. Once you found your place there, shout hallelujah. You know, now this kind of word that I'm preaching, it'll cause folk to run out of the church. There are people that's in the church right now. Get out of here, get out of here, get out of here, get out of here. Why? Because, see, the devil don't want you to hear the word of faith. He wants you to stay in fear. He wants you to stay in doubt. Do you realize the devil comes to church? And we know that he comes to church because Jesus said he comes in sheep's clothing, but inwardly he's a ravening wolf, meaning he's out to tear up something. He's out to tear apart something, but he comes to church. Now that is sick, to come to church and you're not coming to church to hear the word. You're not coming to church for the right reason. You're not coming to church, but you come to church. Why? Because you come with sheep's clothing. But inwardly, Jesus said, you got to, listen, you got to have the Holy Spirit to discern. Something's wrong with this picture. Something's wrong with this person. Something's wrong.
Thank you for watching It's All About Him Ministries with Bishop Nate and Valerie Holcomb. If you'd like to purchase a copy of today's message, please log on to our website at www.chop.org. If you're ever in the area, please join us for any and all of our worship services at 3300 East Stanchthru Loop in Kaloon. Services are held on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m.